Hi viewers, this is BKR Physics Classes. I'm coming with the topic from AC currents, alternating currents, that is most important topic, LCR circuit for all the CBSE students of class 12th. See, LCR circuit in the sense, when we are applying the AC voltage to the elements of resistance and inductor and capacitors which are connected in a series. Till now we have studied in previous videos AC circuit or AC voltage we have applied for in resistor individually, means that is pure AC resistor circuit, and the same thing we have done with the inductor, that is pure inductive circuit, and we have applied AC to the capacitor also. Though we have applied, but in ideal case we have reached some results, but practically if you take individually also, there is some amount of inductive nature, there is some amount of capacitive nature is appears in the resistance. If you take pure inductive circuit, you'll face some amount of resistance also in that, and at the same time you'll face some amount of capacitance also. Means as per the previous experience, in a case of pure circuit, no circuit is pure in practically. It is possible in ideal case. Okay, so now we will see when we are connecting resistance, inductor and capacitor in series with application of AC voltage. Now, when you have applied AC voltage to the LCR circuit, first, let me see, since they have connected in series, the current flowing through the three components is constant, right? So, current is same, in the same direction, but there is a chance voltage may vary, okay? So, the varying voltage is nothing but, through the resistance, if you are seeing, that V equal to IR, means in the direction of current only we can obtain the voltage. But coming to the inductor, case of resistance, the current is in the direction of voltage, and whereas coming to the, in a case of inductor, the current lagging behind the source voltage, and whereas in a capacitor, current is leading the source voltage. So see, the current vector and voltage vector are drawn in the same direction. And coming to the inductor, source is leading, behind the source the current with the 90 degrees, it is showing the phase difference. And coming to the capacitance of the capacitor, when you have applied the source, AC source, in that case current is leading, whereas source is behind the current with the 90 degrees phase. Okay, so altogether, whenever it has applied in a series, let me see, we have a differential form of equation, that is when you have applied the AC source, that is L equal to di by dt. Okay, so here let me see, across the inductance, V equal to L into di by dt, means L is a coefficient of inductance, and the reactance in a case of inductor is XL, that is L into omega. Now when current passes through this inductor, so L into di by dt, change in the current with respect to time, produces some EMF across that. Now IR, when current passes through the resistance, then it opposes some amount of current by the resistance, that is I into R plus Q by C, means the voltage across the capacitance when you have applied the source, right? Now here, this is, we have obtained all this theory in a series from the Kirchhoff's voltage law. We have algebraic sum of the voltages across the closed loop equal to 0. So that is L into di by dt plus I into R plus Q by C equal to total voltage, maximum voltage which we have applied. Okay. So this equation we have to solve now. There is a two methods to solve this. One is phasor diagram solution, the other one is analytical method. Before going to the analytical method, we will solve with the phasor diagram. What are the phasor diagrams? Phasor diagrams in the sense, in the form of vectors with phase difference. Phasor diagram solution, if we see, let me see, here I have drawn the phases of current and voltage. For example, current passing through the resistance, if you are taking voltage across the resistance and the current flowing through the resistance are in the same direction. Okay, here zero phase difference between the voltage and current in a case of resistor circuit that we have discussed also in a pure resistive circuit. Now coming to the inductor, already I have told here, an inductor source is leading with the 90 degrees with respect to the current. Now if you are taking, this is a current, since current is constant, with one current only I am representing, I am comparing the voltages of different components. So here inductor voltage, if you see, inductor voltage is 90 degrees ahead than the current, means it is leading the source in a case of inductor. Now coming to the capacitor, in capacitor the current is leading and source is behind the current, so with the 90 degrees, that's why the capacitance quite opposite to the inductor voltage. So capacitive voltage is quite opposite. Why I have said, since it is also 90 degrees phase, this is also 90 degrees phase with respect to the current, but this is behind the current, the capacitive source, and the inductive source ahead the current, so that's why I have written opposite. This diagram in a vector form, if I'll write vector form, see here, you are seeing in vector form, this is a vector of maximum voltage when you have supplied to the resistive circuit. Okay, across this is indicating the voltage across the resistance, and this is nothing but the maximum voltage which we have supplied from the source. With that, there is a phase is pi. Now here you are seeing 90 degrees phase means resistance voltage, means whatever the voltage across this resistance is, with the 90 degrees phase with the inductor as well as with the capacitance. So that's why this is 90 degrees phase I have written. VL plus VC I have written. Okay, means the magnitude I am expressing in this form. Now this is 90 degrees phase with respect to the voltage vector. In the middle we are having the maximum voltage which we have supplied. With respect to that vector, if I'll form triangle like this with the pi, vectorially if I wanted to express, this gives VCM minus VLM. What is that VCM minus VLM? This is a VL plus VC. For that VL plus VC is acting like one vector only. Okay, VL plus VC with respect to vector quantities we are expressing, since they are opposite direction, voltage in a capacitor, maximum voltage in a capacitor minus maximum voltage in a inductor, that is this, because these are opposite vectors. Okay, for this the opposite vector is this, so that's why here we are relating with this triangle. Okay, therefore I have related with this triangle. Now just now I told, this is the maximum current which we are supplying, the total voltage in the circuit across the loop from the Kirchhoff's voltage law, Vm equal to Vr plus Vc plus Vl. I've told Vr is, since the current is same, and to the inductor and as well as capacitor also current is same, but the voltage is acting as sum of these two vectors. How sum of the two vectors I am taking, since they are opposite, usually the diagram I can draw like this, if this is a resistance and the current direction, this is the voltage across the inductor is more maximum. This is voltage across the capacitance. Since these two are opposite, when I am taking the resultant of this in one direction, for example, this is actually this VL, VC, V all are indicating the amplitudes. This length of the amplitudes, these vectors are indicating. Why I am representing in a form of vector, in the sense, this is all indicating the length of the amplitude of particular voltages. So here voltage source in a case of inductor, it is maximum with respect to comparing with the capacitance. If you take in such a way, then we can write in opposite direction up to here. This, if you are subtracting, this is VC in opposite direction. This part of the magnitude, can I write? I can write VC minus VL. This part of the magnitude I can write. Since it is opposite, when I am trying to subtract, because I need to take the sum of the voltage in inductor as well as in a capacitor. So that I am representing in terms of magnitude, that is VCM minus VLM. Nothing but this is VCM minus VLM. That is the magnitude part is this. In opposite direction. Why I took opposite direction? VC is downwards, VL is upwards. Okay? So that I am writing in a vectorially from this triangle. See, from this triangle, which is having the phase difference phi, from that I am writing, this is VM I set, maximum voltage. Okay, VM, this vector. The VM square hypotenuse is equal to, from the Pythagoras theorem, VM square equal to VRM square plus this part of the vector, which is opposite to the sum of the voltages of inductor and current, that is VCM minus VLM, that is this whole square. Okay, since already we know the from the pure AC resistance circuit, inductive circuit, and pure AC capacitance circuit, VM square equal to, I can write VRM square in the sense I into R square, means I R whole square I can write. Next, from BCM minus LCM. From VCM I can write, this is in a case of capacitance. Since this is an inductive reactance, in a capacitance also we have capacitive reactance is there. Okay, that we can write XL equal to 1 by C omega, reciprocal here. 1 by C omega. This is XC, this is XL. So VCM I can write in terms of XC. XC I into XC, where I is common, XC is resistance in the capacitance, that is nothing but capacitive reactance. This is I into XL whole square we will write. Okay, so from this I am taking I common. Whenever I will take I common, I have I square and R square plus XC minus XL whole square. From this, if I make I as a subject, okay, if I apply the square that side, so VM bar under root of R square plus XC minus XL whole square. This I is gives us amplitude of the current in the LCR circuit. In the LCR circuit, this I gives us amplitude of the current. This I am writing in terms of impedance. What is the impedance? Impedance is nothing but it is a resistance in the LCR circuit. That is I equal to VM by Z I am writing, where the maximum voltage you have supplied across these three components, the current which is flowing through the circuit is constant, and this Z is equal to this part. Okay, under root of R square plus XC minus XL whole square. Z is nothing but impedance. This is most important word. Means impedance is impeding the current in the circuit, LCR circuit. Means this is acting as a resistance in the LCR circuit. Here it is resistance. That resistance also I can call in this circuit impedance. Here it is inductive reactance. That is also I can call as impedance. Okay. And here capacitive reactance. That is also I can call impedance that. Because impedance is nothing but analogy of resistance in the LCR circuit. That is this. This I can obtain if I can erase this. I can obtain from the diagram of that, from this vector diagram, this part VCM minus VLM. So VCM minus VLM in the sense that is like this. Since V is directly proportional to R, here VL is directly proportional to XL, VC is directly proportional to XC, and from the diagram also I can take, since they are having the phase difference pi, this pi, VRM means V, R is directly proportional to resistance. When current is constant only, this is applicable. So this become resistance. Okay, this become XC minus XL, and this will become the maximum voltage in that. This is the maximum voltage. So maximum voltage VM is directly proportional to Z. Okay, whenever the current is constant, if current you take constant, VM is directly proportional to Z. So that Z is this. That comes from this. This is XC minus XL, and this part comes down. That is simply I can write V is directly proportional to R in the sense this is R vector. Now between the R and XC minus XL, if you are obtain a triangle, rectangle triangle, then the total of these two sides is gives the this Z, or the resultant of these two sides gives the Z, which is making angle phi. So this is called impedance. The direction, since it is vectorially I have represented in terms of phase diagrams, so direction of this I can write from this tan pi equal to tan angle. Tan pi is nothing but indicating the direction of the impedance. So tan pi equal to, I can write simply XC minus XL by R. So I got the direction of impedance, that is this, and the phase angle is pi, pi equal to tan inverse XC minus XL. Now from this IM equal to VM by Z, in this XC minus XL is equal to, already I have shown in the diagram, with respect to that, the impedance circuit, the impedance, how it will be changes in this, from this phase angle by using. Usually there are the two cases, XC minus XL means, for example, resistance increases in the capacitance, nothing but capacitive reactance is more than the inductive reactance, then that circuit predominative capacitive circuit. Okay, means in this case the current is ahead and the voltage is behind that. Current is leading in the capacitance. And next, if you are taking XL greater than XC, this is predominantly inductive circuit. What is that? Inductive circuit. So in this case, source is leading and behind the source the current with the 90 degrees angle. Okay, these are the important points which we can obtain, the phase relation we can obtain from the phasor diagrams only. So that's why phasor diagram solution is useful to understand the phase of the impedance which is produced in a AC circuit, that is in a LCR circuit especially. Okay, We will discuss in the next class analytical solution. Thank you very much. Please subscribe my video. Hi viewers, this is BKR Physics Classes. I'm coming with the topic from AC currents, alternating currents, that is most important topic, LCR circuit for all the CBSE students of class 12th. See, LCR circuit in the sense, when we are applying the AC voltage to the elements of resistance and inductor and capacitors which are connected in a series. Till now we have studied in previous videos AC circuit or AC voltage we have applied for in resistor individually, means that is pure AC resistor circuit, and the same thing we have done with the inductor, that is pure inductive circuit, and we have applied AC to the capacitor also. Though we have applied, but in ideal case we have reached some results, but practically if you take individually also, there is, if you are taking resistance, means there is some amount of inductive nature, there is some amount of capacitive nature is appears in the resistance. If you take pure inductive circuit, you'll face some amount of resistance also in that, and at the same time you'll face some amount of capacitance also. Means as per the previous experience, in a case of pure circuit, no circuit is pure in practically. It is possible in ideal case. Okay, so now we will see when we are connecting resistance, inductor and capacitor in series with application of AC voltage. Now, when you have applied AC voltage to the LCR circuit, first let me see, since they have connected in series, the current flowing through the three components is constant, right? So current is same in the same direction, but there is a chance voltage may vary. Okay, so the varying voltage is nothing but through the resistance, if you are seeing that V equal to IR, means in the direction of current only we can obtain the voltage. But coming to the inductor, case of resistance, the current is in the direction of voltage, and whereas coming to the, in a case of inductor, the current lagging behind the source voltage, and whereas in a capacitor, current is leading the source voltage. So see, the current vector and voltage vector are drawn in the same direction. And coming to the inductor, source is leading, behind the source the current with the 90 degrees, it is showing the phase difference. And coming to the capacitance of the capacitor, when you have applied the source, AC source, in that case current is leading, whereas source is behind the current with the 90 degrees phase. Okay, so altogether, whenever it has applied in a series, let me see, we have a differential form of equation, that is when you have applied the AC source, that is L equal to di by dt. Okay, so here let me see, across the inductance, V equal to L into di by dt, means L is a coefficient of inductance, and the reactance in a case of inductor is XL, that is L into omega. Now when current passes through this inductor, so L into di by dt, change in the current with respect to time, produces some EMF across that. Now IR, when current passes through the resistance, then it opposes some amount of current by the resistance, that is I into R plus Q by C, means the voltage across the capacitance when you have applied the source, right? Now here, this is, we have obtained all this theory in a series from the Kirchhoff's voltage law. We have algebraic sum of the voltages across the closed loop equal to 0. So that is L into di by dt plus I into R plus Q by C equal to total voltage, maximum voltage which we have applied. Okay, so this equation we have to solve now. There is a two methods to solve this. One is phasor diagram solution, the other one is analytical method. Before going to the analytical method, we will solve with the phasor diagram. What are the phasor diagrams? Phasor diagrams in the sense, in the form of vectors with phase difference.